everyone. Miss Elaine here at the Bethel Park Community Center for a very special No Cook Tuesday story time. Joining me today is my special friend Nora, and you can join us too because No Cook Tuesdays are here every Tuesday from 4 to 7 at the Community Center. So I heard there's some food trucks coming in a little bit, so I chose some fun food stories, sort of. This one is actually called the Halloweener, and it's about a dog, a wiener dog, that dresses up like a hot dog for Halloween. Okay, do you know this story? You do? It's a fun one, it's one of my favorites. So let's read it together. There once was a dog named Oscar, who was half a dog tall and one and a half dogs long. Have you ever seen a long dog like that? No? Do you have a dog at home? Do you? What's your dog's name? Aw. Well, this dog, his name is Oscar. Because of his unusual shape and size, all the other dogs made fun of him. Wiener dog, they called him. Is that very nice? No. And Oscar did not like it one bit. Of course he didn't. How do you think that made him feel? Sad? Yeah, I think I would be sad too. Oscar's mother was no help either. Every morning when the dogs walked off to obedience school, Oscar's mother stood in the front yard, waving and calling out, "Farewell, my little Vienna sausage!" And all the other dogs laughed and laughed. Most of the time, Oscar was upset by all of this. But not today. Today was Halloween, and Oscar was thinking about other things. All day long at obedience school, Oscar daydreamed about Halloween night, trick-or-treats, and scary costumes. When Oscar got home, he dashed upstairs to start working on his scary Halloween costume. But when he got to his room, a surprise was waiting for him. "Happy Halloween, my little sausage link," said Oscar's mother. "I've made you a costume to wear for trick-or-treat." Oh, she made him a homemade costume, right? And she put it in this long box. What do you think it is? What do you think she made him? A hot dog. It was a giant hot dog bun, complete with mustard. And guess who was supposed to fit in the middle? Oscar didn't want to hurt his mother's feelings, so he decided to wear the silly costume. That night, all the dogs on the block gathered to show off their costumes. Everyone was looking quite scary. Then Oscar showed up, looking quite frank. I wouldn't consider his costume scary, would you? Yeah, hot dog's not really scary. When the dogs saw Oscar in his silly costume, they howled with laughter. "Look at Oscar," they cried. "He really is a wiener dog." Poor Oscar was so embarrassed. Wiener dog," laughed the other dogs as they ran off to go trick-or-treating. Oscar tried to keep up with the other dogs, but his silly costume kept slowing him down. All night long, the other dogs hounded every treat they could get their paws on. So by the time Oscar got to each house, there were no treats left. Soon, trick-or-treating was over, and the dogs walked home past a spooky graveyard. Suddenly, a horrible hissing sound filled the air. Hiss! The dogs stopped dead in their tracks. What do you think is making that hissing sound? What do you think? You think it's the hot dog? I wonder. Then, out of the graveyard, rode a ghastly monster. The dogs screamed for their lives. They dropped their treats and jumped into a nearby pond. think this creature right here is scaring them off. The monster moved closer. "Please don't eat us," cried the dogs. You see little dog feet, little paws down there? Very good observation. The monster yowled and hissed. "Boo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo," sobbed the dogs. The monster jumped up and down. "Somebody save us," shrieked the dogs. Just then, somebody showed up. It was Oscar. Because Oscar was so short, he saw something the other dogs had not seen. "That's no monster," cried Oscar. And with a loud bark, Oscar waddled to the rescue. Oscar chomped and tugged with all of his might. I don't know if there are little dog paws under there, but it's definitely some animal creature, right? We know it's not really a monster or a scarecrow come to life. You think maybe the cat? Well, Nora, that might be a really good guess. Rip! And there, standing in the moonlight, were a couple of ornery cats. You guessed it. "Help!" cried the cats. "We're being attacked by a giant Frankfurter!" And they ran off screaming through the graveyard. The dogs in the pond had seen the whole thing, and now it was their turn to be embarrassed. "We've been chased into a pond by a couple of cats," they moaned. But Oscar was a true friend. He leaped into the water and swam out to the dogs. Oscar's silly costume made a wonderful life raft, and all the dogs climbed up. "All aboard," Oscar called, and he doggy paddled back to shore. That was a really kind thing for him to do, wasn't it? Even though they were laughing at him earlier and making fun of poor Oscar, he still chose to be kind to them in the end, when they really needed a friend. When they got back to dry land, all the dogs shared their Halloween treats with Oscar. Because Oscar had been so brave, the dogs changed his name from Wiener Dog to Hero Sandwich. And from that night on, nobody ever made fun of Oscar again. The end. Happy Halloween. Yeah, so he was a true friend to them, huh?
Hi, I'm Kathy Moscato, Bethel Park Assistant Recreation Director, and I'm excited to tell you that No Cook Tuesdays will be returning to the Community Center Playground parking lot October 5th, running from 4 to 7 p.m. through November 23rd. No Cook Tuesdays will bring you a variety of food vendors every Tuesday, so you can come and pick up your dinner and not have to cook. Looking forward to seeing you here on Tuesdays, 4 to 7 p.m.
Awesome. Would you like to read another story with me? I heard there's going to be a hot dog truck here, and I also heard there's going to be a barbecue truck here. So I thought we'd read this story next, and this one's called Take Me to Your Barbecue. And guess what? Aliens come down from outer space, and they land on this guy's farm. Yeah, and they want him to teach them all sorts of things, and I guess they want to try out some barbecue. Take me to your barbecue. See, there he is on his farm. Looks like he has a dog as a pet, too. A tractor. This is his house, and he's cooking up something yummy over here on this grill. Yippee-ki-yay, yippee-ki-yo. I think I see a UFO. Some colored lights from outer space are lighting up the whole dang place. The UFO is landing on his farm. What is he gonna do? I wonder if the farmer's scared. Or I wonder if he's curious. Cats meowing, cows a-lowing, dogs a-howling, chickens glowing. Unearthly platter, huge and round, is beaming rays down to the ground. See all these lights coming down from their ship, from the UFO? It's kind of scaring all the animals, right? They don't know what to think. Yippee-ki-yay, yippee-ki-yee! A big blue light is shining on me. It's coming down by my front porch. I hope my little shack don't scorch. He's hoping his house doesn't catch on fire or something, right? I think he is a little scared. Definitely a little bit worried. My roof's on fire! Rockers charred. Small green men swarm through my yard. Uh-oh. Here come the aliens. Now, do they look like mean aliens? No, they kind of look friendly to me, don't you think? They're smiling. Three eyes, three teeth, but they look like they're grinning. Howdy, partner, the boss man beeps. His three big eyes give me the creeps. Yippee-ki-yay, yippee-ki-yay. I think they might take me away. Uh-oh. He's definitely worried. But I think they just want to shake his hand. Right? They're just introducing themselves. You think he's going to steal his cowboy hat? Oh, look, yeah. Maybe he does want it. We don't want your leader, Willie. Just your barbecue and chili. Fire up the grill and put on the beans. Chop up peppers, taters, and greens. He took his hat and he's ordering himself some food. He's like, give me a taste of your chili, sir. And he's replacing the cowboy hat with a chef's hat. That's right, he wants him to cook. These aliens are hungry. Little guys eat barbecue, then gobble up my hat and shoes. The barbecue wasn't enough. Look, they're putting ketchup on his boot, and they're gonna eat his boot too. Yippee-ki-yay, yippee-ki-yoo. Green men line up, two by two. Willie, we want to do-si-do. Play your fiddle before we go. So first they ordered him to cook them up some food, and now they're telling him to play some music. They're like, we want to dance. Play your fiddle. Greenies two-step, mighty hard, and they wear a hole plumb through my yard. Those little fellas just won't stop. I keep on fiddling till they drop. So they dance themselves crazy until they can't dance anymore, right? And then they're all plopping down. They are tired. Yippee-ki-yo, yippee-ki-yi. I think it's time to say goodbye. So long, greenies. Enjoy your stay. I'm going for a holiday. Wait a second. They might have stolen his hat, but what did Farmer Willie do? Did he steal their spaceship? Is that him in there? Yeah, he says, I'm going for a holiday. See you later. Holiday means like a vacation, right? So he's taking off, and he's cruising through outer space, I guess, right? I wonder where he's going to go. Oh, my goodness. What's going on? Yeah, that sign says Willie's Barbecue. So the aliens are with him too there. They're enjoying his food. What are they doing over here? Planting some more food, right? Where is Willie? I don't know, but check it out. In the back of the story, they give you a recipe for Willie's famous barbecue sauce. You could try making that at home. Yeah. I don't know. Do you think they teamed up and they opened a barbecue joint together? And then he put the aliens to work. They had to plan him some more food. What do you think? Have you ever tried anything with barbecue flavor on it? Barbecue chicken or barbecue potato chips or barbecued pork? That all sounds pretty yummy to me. Sometimes at these food truck fests or these farmers markets, you might see people selling fruit too. Like you can buy apples and such. So I also have a story here that's called Apple Farmer Annie. Would you like to listen to this one? Yeah? Let's do it. This one's written by Monica Wellington. Annie is an apple farmer. She has a big orchard of apple trees. In the fall, she picks baskets and baskets of round, ripe apples. Do you like apples? Friends at home, do you like apples? Me too, they are delicious. And they're healthy for us too. She grows many kinds of apples. She sorts and organizes them. How is she organizing them? Is she doing it by color? You got your red apples, your yellow apples, your green apples. Here the dog's running off with an apple. Annie uses some of the apples to make sweet apple cider. She uses others to make delicious, smooth apple sauce. That sounds yummy too, doesn't it? She loves baking muffins, cakes, and pies with her apples. But she saves the most beautiful ones of all to sell fresh at the market. So there she is, she's loading up her truck and she's gonna go sell these apples. She loads everything into her truck and drives to the city. Annie, the apple farmer, sets up her stand in the farmer's market. So she's selling apples and muffins and cakes and pies and apple cider. Do you think she'll get any customers? Let's find out. Oh, look. Lots of customers come to Annie's stand. She is busy all day long. They all want to buy her apples and apple treats. By the end of the day, she has sold everything. She packs up to go home. Annie is tired but happy. It feels so good to have her own apple farm. And look, she's eating an apple herself, a little bedtime snack. And here's some more recipes in the back of this book that teaches you how to make apple sauce, apple muffins, apple cake. Yummy. Are you getting hungry yet, Nora? My friends at home, are you getting hungry? All this reading about food sure is making me hungry.
Hi, I'm Kathy Moscato, Bethel Park Assistant Recreation Director, and I'm excited to tell you that No Cook Tuesdays will be returning to the Community Center Playground parking lot October 5th, running from 4 to 7 p.m. through November 23rd. No Cook Tuesdays will bring you a variety of food vendors every Tuesday, so you can come and pick up your dinner and not have to cook. Looking forward to seeing you here on Tuesdays, 4 to 7 p.m.
I'll read you one more story. I want you to put your hands up in the air like this. Stretch them up. And we're going to pretend we're an apple tree. Way up high in an apple tree, two red apples smiled down at me. I shook that tree as hard as I could. Down came the apples and good. Do you like apples? Yeah, apples are a delicious treat. Let's do that again. Reach your arms up. Way up high in an apple tree, two red apples smiled down at me. I shook that tree as hard as I could. Down came the apples and good. One more time, arms up. Way up high in an apple tree, two red apples smiled down at me. I shook that tree as hard as I could. Down came the apples and good. All right, let's do our last story. It is called Food Truck Fest. And that's what I see arriving right here at the community center right now. The food trucks are coming and they're gonna have lots of delicious things to sell. Over at the depot and up with the sun, the food trucks get ready. Today will be fun. Time to hustle. There's prep work to do. Bring in the groceries. Here comes the crew. Let's get moving. There's no time to rest. Everybody's going to the food truck fest. See, they're loading up all their trucks too. I wonder what they're going to sell. You know, apple farmer Annie, she sold apples. What are these guys going to sell? Family's up. It's a hullabaloo. First, get dressed. Where's baby's shoe? The sky is clear, the weather's great, the lines get long, so we can't be late. Let's get moving, no time to rest. Everybody's going to the food truck fest. So this whole family is gonna go, right? And he's getting dressed and the baby can't find her shoe, but they're trying to hurry up so they can get there because they're so excited. Check the recipe, start to cook. Peek inside for a closer look. Some trucks have ovens. Others have grills. They're kitchens on wheels without the frills. It's weird to think about how a kitchen can be inside of a truck like that, huh? They do. They fit in a stove or they fit in a grill so they can make the food. Each cook has a special job preparing for the hungry mob. Washing and drying, mincing and slicing, mixing and stirring. He's making icing. Let's get moving. No time to rest. Everybody's going to the food truck fest. So we saw the family getting ready to go, and these are the cooks, the chefs, who are getting ready for the customers to come. Blanket, bug spray, sunblock too. Bags are packed, but where's that shoe? Let's get moving. No time to rest. Everybody's going to the food truck fest. Engines rumble and then start to roar. Close the windows, shut the door. Ready and loaded with tons of good eats, the fleet of mighty food trucks take to the streets. There's a long line of food trucks, isn't there? So there's going to be lots of different types of food to try. I think this is an ice cream truck. You can get dessert here. What else will there be? Let's keep reading. Uh-oh, blocked bridge. What can the trucks do? The festival's today. They need to get through. If they can't drive across, then they'll have to float. Hurry up, drive aboard the big ferry boat. The ferry is fast. The trip will be quick. The river is rough, but the trucks don't get sick. So you have to go across the water to get there. Hold the ferry. Wait, wait, wait. Four more passengers run through the gate. Let's get moving. No time to rest. Everybody's going to the food truck fest. The caravan arrives along with a crowd that's excited and eager and rowdy and loud. Let's get moving. No time to rest. Everybody's going to the food truck fest. The cooks get to work serving up lunch. The lines may be long, but there are samples to munch. There's this morsel called falafel, or polish off a Belgian waffle. Kimchi tacos, that's no illusion. Korean and Mexican make a tasty fusion. I've never tasted that, but it sounds yummy. Have you ever had a Belgian waffle?
I have, with strawberries and whipped cream on top. It is so delicious.
Have you ever had falafel?
No, that's a Mediterranean.
You had this down here?
No.
Oh, a Belgian waffle.
Yeah
me
but
too.
No strawberries.
No strawberries. Did you put syrup on it?
Yeah.
Folks settle down with their hot dogs and ices, burritos, kebabs, pretzels, and slices. A band's playing tunes and everyone's eating. With such tasty food, who really needs seating? They don't need to sit down. They kind of just walk around and eat the food. Some maybe will sit on a blanket and have a picnic. Before too long, it's time for dessert. Will you choose ice cream or frozen yogurt? What do you like for dessert? You like ice cream? Me too. And there's always room for ice cream. Soon the trucks serve up their very last snack. It's time to pack up. They're all going back. Home to the depot while it's still light to scrub and clean up. Sweet dreams. Good night. They spent the whole day there, and now they're tired. The kids fell asleep in the car, didn't they? The end, and that's all about food trucks. And so maybe today you could sample something from the food trucks that are here at the community center. So story time is all wrapped up, but you can see the food trucks starting to arrive behind me. Don't forget to stop by and give them a try. They're here every Tuesday from 4 to 7 p.m. from now until November 23rd. And don't forget to check out the library's Facebook page to see when I may be popping up here again too.